Hello and welcome back for Game 3, where CounterLogic Gaming will be facing off against Echo Fox. I am Rivington Bizden III, and don't tell my co-caster Sam Kobe Hartman Kanzler, but I went mad money with his entire stock portfolio, and now he owns a beet farm.
I trust you very much, Riv.
Let's take a look at the starting lineups, see who's going to be making the money this game. On the blue side, it's CounterLogic Gaming. That means in the top lane, it is Ruin. Roaming around in the jungle is Wiggly, mid laner, Power of Evil, Stixxay at bot with his support, Biofrost, and Coach Weldon and Irene.
Facing them on the red side will be Echo Fox in the top lane, Solo in the jungle, Rush, mid Phoenix. Back in, also Apollo in bottom lane, supporting Hakuo and coaches Song and Tyler on stage.
That's right, a lot of teams mixing and matching this week. And while CLG continued to show inconsistencies in their performance, the boys in black did pick up a feel-good win versus Team Liquid to close out their week two.
Yeah, and that was on a Stixxay Caitlyn game. He is bringing it back, one of his all-time best champions. And that was alongside Biofrost on yet another long-range, high-damage AP support. I really do think this is a good direction for CLG to be going in for that bottom lane. Very long range, harassment oriented, being a power point for the team.
Yep, and they test that style with the reunion of Apollo and Hakuo in the bot lane for Echo Fox, the poster child duo of consistency for so long in the LCS.
Yeah, reunited here once again. Apollo and Phoenix are both back in, so that means Apollo and Hakuo together, pairing that has made LCS playoffs three times themselves and have so many games together, will be happy to be on stage once again. I have to say, a lot of Echo Fox's success has been off of solo in the top side. So maybe with this swap, putting Phoenix back in mid lane, putting Apollo back on the bottom side of the map, if that stabilizes the rest of it for solo, he has had a standout performance
this
summer.
He really has. And going up against Ruin this game, Ruin himself has said he's felt a little like he's playing behind his potential. The team has been doing a great job at picking up his slack. So solo could be going even harder this game to take control. Echo Fox has been playing quite a bit of engage, hard engage. So anything that goes behind that and solo is going to be good for them.
Yeah, I especially like the triple goose egg. Perfect KDA there for him in the early game. Not a lot of action early, but it has been late game carries for him.
And it's kind of been a long road for solo. We would see him be tacked on 3v1s in the top lane. He gets taken down. It's hard games, hard games. And now he's kind of learned how to play against that pressure, has a great absorption of pressure in the top, and really can change how the game plays for his team by just doing that play style. Looking around the map, we do have Apollo, as you said, back in along with Phoenix. We're talking about how Stixxay is stepping back at the AD carry, but we're going to have to see how Apollo can do back in his Echo Fox main team shoes.
Yep, and once again, will they be going up against CLG trying to draft for bottom lane dominance? Because this is something not a lot of the other teams have been doing. We saw Zyra in the bottom side for Biofrost, as well as the Yuumi game. Don't think Yuumi's going to get through again.
I don't.
We've got a slight delay on stage, though, so we can hypothesize a little more.
I don't, but that's a great point, because when we saw Biofrost on TSM, I remember starting out in his Karma game, flashing forward just above mid. I remember him going aggressive. So he's always had a pretty big variety in champion pools, and now he's bringing out the Lux. He's bringing out a few other things, and we're seeing a lot of this utility play come from Biofrost, whereas before he would be himself on the Braum, on something to kind of just support the one carry in his lane, which would be Stixxay. Now he can start the plays for his team, and it seems to be working out. Wiggly on things like Sejuani and Jarvan to get that fuse lit, and the team's right behind both of them.
Yeah, this is going to be a critical game for both teams, too, because currently CLG are sitting at 2-2 in the standings. We're able to get back to 50% after taking down Team Liquid last week. In typical CLG fashion, nice surprise there for them. And Echo Fox are only 1-3, so they're really trying to correct the early start that they've had.
It was pretty insane the way they were doing it, too. You remember the old rotatos you would hear from CounterLogic Gaming. They're in one lane, then they're in another lane, and they were moving so quick. Hard to communicate that and do each game, though. So we'll see if they can make it happen here. CounterLogic Gaming and Echo Fox are two of the teams that will always have a good matchup. We always say wins are important, but if you know you can get a win over a team that might be another 50-50, 60-40 game down the line, you want to get that win now. You want to be able to get that score a lot better, so your chances of dropping one of those games that aren't so for sure later don't hurt as much. Slight delay on stage, as we said before, waiting to get a few more members in on that. So with Hakuo and Apollo back in on the team, like you said, towards that bot lane. We're going to have to see if maybe that takes pressure off of Phoenix. He's had either really high highs or really low lows for himself. You have the Phoenix Azir plays, or you kind of have, wait, where is Phoenix? We know he's in this game, but he hasn't made an impact yet.
Yeah, historically, Phoenix has had fairly dominating mid lane statistics as far as the early game, his lane pressure, but dramatically low warding for this guy. And even talking to Mark, who is a former coach of Phoenix and a couple of other coaches, like, this is a guy where they've talked about, okay, yeah, just need to get a little bit more vision for Phoenix to be able to play aggressively, as he likes to try and get those solo advantages in his lane in 1v1 scenarios. But that might be an area that could be punished by enemy junglers. I think that Wiggly for CLG was also a standout performer in their victories. His Sejuani initiations were very quick. Yeah, exactly, right? He did not hesitate, and CLG benefited greatly from that. And he'll be going up against Rush, former MVP of the LCS, yeah, but that was quite a long time ago.
And I feel like it's different play styles that they'll see. We've seen Wiggly on that Rek'Sai, but Rush will love to be on the Olaf, love to be on the early aggression where Wiggly wants to farm for the fights. Like you said, having that Sejuani to get a Glacial Prison out and get the engages over the wall. Everybody's been following up on CLG, though, so I think whatever comp they get together with, everybody's in on that call, whether it's bad or good. And it's one of the things they've been building on is the miscommunication or not having everyone on the same page. And I think having Ruin in now kind of leveled out the voices across the board, right? You have Darshan in there. He's the veteran. This guy speaks. You're going to listen to him. That call is going to be made, whether it's kind of good or bad. But I think, from my point of view, giving everybody else a bigger voice now, as you see Biofrost, Stixxay, everybody else being able to chatter, is giving the diversity that CLG needed to enter into these engages where they're finding themselves coming out on top.
Yeah, it's very interesting listening to each of the individual teams' personal content, because lots of them talk about the communication in different instances. And one of the big ones for CLG, as you're mentioning, is how calm Ruin is. He calms everyone else down. It's nice to have that presence and doesn't overload the communications in-game, which, of course, can get super hectic. And they say a similar thing for Echo Fox, though, as Rush and multiple members of the team have talked about, just trying to get the players to see the game the same way so that you have the same reactions in different scenarios is a struggle that most LCS teams and most competitive teams do have to constantly work through. Sometimes adding new players or switching old players back in can completely change the way a team operates without necessarily relying on the individual on-stage performance of their mechanics or anything.
Yeah, we even see, you know, Cloud9 switched one out today to just try something new.
Turbocharge him with Blabber.
Yeah, turbocharged indeed. I'll be getting into this one quite shortly here into Champion Select to see what Echo Fox has for Counter-Logic Gaming. And the other way around, looks like CLG will be on blue for this one to start it off. And it looks like the game will be starting with the referee's words from the lobby. So we're gonna be seeing what homework has been done.
Woo-hoo!
Who's gonna be able to get the victory on this one? Counter-Logic Gaming versus Echo Fox, and we are in two picks and bans.
All right, all of our discussion and deliberation over the bottom lanes. will we start to see the focus there? Yuumi is definitely the permaban, close to permaban for the bottom side, because of the oppressive poke, and definitely necessary, especially against CLG, but we consider more continued focus on the bottom side here, with Sona as well being taken off the table.
Might see Lux out there as well. The Rumble, Solo's side gonna take that one out. I figure Ruin might be able to do something dirty with it if he gets it in his hands. 20 seconds left on this final ban for phase one of Counter-Logic Gaming. What do they want to take away from Echo Fox?
Yeah, this is looking already like we're going to leave quite a bit on the table. You can't now ban out Sylas and Akali and Aurelia and Ryze and Aatrox. There's so many of these typical power picks that are going to be let through.
Even more left up.
Yeah, because of these target bans. Another target ban here, the LeBlanc off the table away from Phoenix. Power of Evil generally does play big AP threats that don't have dashes. So a little bit less mobile, and they don't want PoE to get camped early on. Rush is definitely a jungler that will focus on a lane and try to hard camp it. They don't want PoE to be the one receiving that. The Aatrox will be the one they won't let through. So let's see which of those remaining flex picks they do go with. Ryze, Aurelia, as well as Akali. My personal favorite, of course, for pro play still is Ryze. But Sylas as well, a lot of the teams consider just on the same power level of the Aatrox in terms of later in the game, how hard you can crush through stealing so many ultimates. Mm-hmm. To be able to still take it this early,
Is it the ability of the ultimate and movement, or just Ryze kit all around for you?
It's the damage output and the possibilities of split pushing with the utility of your ultimate surprise Baron move.
So you bring more strategies like to the team with Ryze as well.
Meanwhile, the Sylas here for CLG is a point of power you have to play off. So them power picking this early on, whether it goes top, whether it goes mid, I think should be an early focus.
There's that Sejuani taken away from Wiggly. They're going to let their jungler go away. First phase through, Zaya Rakan picked up for that bot lane. Great fight comp coming out of CLG so far. Mecha Fox always liking to make that engage comp so far from what we've seen in this summer split. Let's see what their final pick is.
All right, Sejuani works best when you have other melee champions to help stack up the passive for the stun very quickly. And there we go. We do get the melee for the top side. Solo once again. Huge carry performance. He did almost 50% of the team's damage last time he got his hands on Gangplank. And since they do have an early Sejuani pick here, maybe they actually send some jungle attention that way.
I remember him tweeting something like, welcome to the God Plank after that. He definitely knew he had a good game and he was feeling it all the way into next week. Kennen banned out by Echo Fox here as we get into the second phase of bans. And Chronologic Gaming looks to hit that support tree of Hakuo back in the mix.
All right, Kennen taken off the table as well because they don't want that matchup into Gangplank a little bit too oppressive early on. And Ruin has also put up a lot of games with Kennen. See if they followed up with another top lane targeted or if they switched over to jungle. It is the Rek'Sai. So Wiggly not only is the victim of stealing Sejuani away in the early phase here for Rush, but also taking off the Rek'Sai for possible early moves in the game. I'd say the only other like super powerful early movers are AP threats. And since Sylas has already picked up, you have to worry about having triple AP. Sometimes if you ban out some AD junglers like Rek'Sai, then you can balance that a little bit easier. I guess Jarvan's still available though, if they wanted to go that route.
Jarvan, possible Olaf. Quite a few things to run through though if you're Olaf and probably still going down. Tahm Kench locked in the side of Echo Fox. A lot of mobility between Realm Warp, Abyssal Voyage, and the ability for Cannon Barrage to be at the fight before the team is able to engage. Stixxay with his patented Warwick hover, as he always does in Champion Select before the team gets their pick in 5 seconds.
I also think Tahm Kench is not a very great ultimate for Sylas to steal. The main ones Sylas is looking to steal are going to be the Sejuani and Gangplank in this game. And the Trundle comes in seeing not only Sejuani, but also TK, both good targets here. Trundle, kind of the classic counter pick to Sejuani, because Sejuani will usually take Aftershock and the passive as well. You can steal those stats, and then once they fall off, Sejuani, of course, can even go negative in stats sometimes. But we've seen adaptations. In the LCK, there was a Hail of Blades Sejuani. I've also seen the Fleet Footwork Sejuanis when they're against a Trundle counter pick, because they know that Aftershock will also have negative consequences for them. Some people just ignore it, you know, and still go for the Aftershock because there are scenarios where Trundle won't be there, but definitely could take a different Keystone to try and counter.
All right, how are we liking these lanes, Kobe? Obviously, the duo of lovers duo of Zaya Rakan, quite strong in the lane, but you're not going to always get too much onto a Tahm Kench and an Ezreal that can play safe. That mid lane of Syndra, Ryze, and the top half of the map looking pretty fight-worthy. How are you feeling?
Feeling quite safe here for the bottom half of the map for CLG. You mentioned the Ezreal Tahm Kench. That is one of the safest lanes. So I expect CLG to have priority in the bottom lane with the Zaya and Rakan. And while Ezreal and Tahm Kench are safe, they don't have a lot of power. So it'll be interesting to see where Echo Fox try and have their jungle placement. We mentioned the Sejuani and Gangplank synergies, but you don't always try and utilize that super early, as Gangplank is a little while to scale.
Good bit of scaling on both sides. You get Apollo, consistent laner, and the bot on Ezreal. Get his farm up. Average lane for him will be good as he gets into the mid game. Just don't go down to the Zaya and the Rakan to start things off. You see the composition in front of you. Both teams looking to put those wins in the left side column. Chronologic Gaming versus Echo Fox about to go on to the Rift. Solo's a big name coming out of this one. Echo Fox has been looking at him for a lot of the power, a lot of the wins they've had coming into each week of the LCS. And again, it's going to be Rush on Saturday. What are they going to be able to do here? What is he going to be able to do? And can they break that curse?
All right. Let's see if the Echo Fox roster switches will bring them a victory or if CLG push above 500 and get their third win.
That's usually something that happens in the middle of the season, so getting up that stairway quite quick here in the beginning for CLG, and we are off and running. Not too much potential for invade here from either squad. No Luxes on the Rift, and also no Yuumi's, as that was banned out quite fast. Teleport for Apollo on his Ezreal, as we would expect. Lethal Tempo on the side for Stixxay, and Guardian for Biofrost.
All right, we got a Sylas invade here with Ruin. Not quite close enough to land the stun, so looks like it's gonna be no engagement early on. I think that this is the way that Echo Fox would like the early game to go. They don't want it to be super action-packed. There's a lot of potential for high damage from a Zaya Rakan combo. Mm-hmm. But remember the changes to Tahm Kench? While they did make it more difficult to use Devour to save your allies because you are slowed an incredible amount whenever you do, they also buffed his straight melee 1v1 dueling. So Tahm Kench into Rakan, Tahm Kench much more health and much more defenses. If you're able to stand there, and we've seen Ole quickly stack up the passive of the Taysair for Tahm Kench. Yep. You can really punish a squishier support like Rakan if you've got someone like Rush around on Sejuani.
Yep, those changes have definitely brought him a little bit more towards the top lane, as you might see in solo queue. Mm. But if you beat him early, you're good to go. Just don't let him. Or if you beat him, yeah, if you beat him early, you can't let him get the win quick. Coming up on 2 minutes, and we are into the laning phase. A little bit of help there for Rush, and the lead for CLG as they try to get a bit of that health advantage down to make sure level two is theirs first. Should be a pretty good back and forth for each lane. Apollo will just farm with his Mystic shots, but Stixxay and Biofrost always going in for the engages.
Yeah, good exchange there from PoE too. You saw all the range minions were attacking Phoenix during the first exchange too, while PoE was far enough away from Phoenix's range minions. He heavily won that trade, getting a decent amount of health. Meanwhile, on the top side here, Solo playing far back, not gonna let Ruin get off any further harassment.
Quick double E, gets himself to safety. Biofrost already looking for the early ward here to make sure he can get through, see if anything spawns. Also make sure he doesn't have to ward back around that top side so he gets run over by Dragon. Nicely done as we see Rush onto the Raptors. Wiggly was making his way around that top scuttle, but as a late spawn happens, we won't see them fight each other.
Yeah, exactly as we are talking about in Champ Select, this is the Zaya Rakan early game. Being able to push in also affords you the extra benefit as you're talking about going up to roam there for Biofrost, getting a ward on the scuttle crab.
See if that pulls Rush down to the bottom side of the map at all as well. He has to go towards the top, as that is his path, but that means Apollo and Haku will get a little less help along the way. If this mid lane continues to get pushed in, that means Power of Evil could get a roam, but damage now to Phoenix. He has no mana force to use the flash to 100 HP, safe behind his turret, as Phoenix is now a disadvantage in mid lane.
Yeah, and I'm a little bit surprised he didn't flash early after the pillar was put down. He really wanted to greet it out and not have to use his flash. But in doing so, he took the bite and the extra auto reset there from Wiggly that had red buff. So a significant amount more of damage taken. Might not matter in the end though, as they're both going for resets. It's gonna be a recall for Power of Evil to walk back. And Phoenix does have teleports.
Might be a reset for that. Good stun range on Power of Evil Scout of the Week. Another pillar, and that is a dead rise. He'll be able to teleport, as you said. May not have to as it reset. May walk back nice and slow. As we get pings down onto the bottom side. And actually, the bot lane pressure of CLG has allowed them to do scuttle.
Oh.
But maybe it's taking them a little bit too long. Flashes over the wall, what's going to keep them safe. And a nice entrance, or you'd say heroic save, coming in from Biofrost to get himself out. Solo now gets the flashes, and across the map, we're seeing summoner spells be used here.
Two ganks for Wiggly, two flashes blown on the solo laners. Meanwhile, yes, their bottom lane did move up to try and get that scuttle crab. That cost their own flash, though, so different areas to focus here for both teams. Rush continue to focus on the mid lane here as he tries to catch PoE a little bit too aggressive. Not going to be the right side of the map, though, as Power of Evil intelligently is hovering on the top side while he knows Rush last spotted on the bottom side of the map, so that would be the only area that he could gank from.
Simple mind games in the beginning, junglers hoping to catch people off guard, just focusing on a CS. Focusing on that flash being down and playing a little too over-aggressive. It's the little things that matter right now, and in 5 minutes, not too much has happened, but it is that 800 gold lead over on the side of Echo Fox. Getting pushed in the bot lane, still great CS coming from Apollo. As we said, very consistent there, just has to hold the pressure off and absorb it.
All right, let's see where we go after the support recalls here, because Hawk goes back out and he's trying to reclaim some of the vision, but they're desynced recalls. With Phoenix back in base, they have no mid lane pressure. It's a little bit dangerous here, so the control wards remain, and Apollo on Ezreal should be safe by himself until they're able to get that cleared.
As we see Hakuo coming back to lane, so probably not too much attention drawn in by this Cloud Drake at the start for either team. All lanes are quite even at the moment. Scryer's Orb from Power of Evil straight up towards the top of the map to make sure he knows what's going on. Krugs is up, so they may be able to figure out that Rush on towards that mid and bottom side of the map. Wiggly takes this chance now to clear out bottom side, knowing that Rush is probably hovering around top.
Yeah, CLG gonna try and push this wave now into tower as quickly as possible. Maybe they have a rotation up towards the mid side, because Rush is actually going top and just showed himself on that ward that was by top lane. So they know the Sejuani whereabouts. See if they can do anything on top of it, though.
Still level 5 for Wiggly. Slow-moving Trundle throws down Frozen Domain. He can get that distance closed onto Phoenix. Flashes down for a little bit longer here. They're going to pull
wrapping
him in.
Around.
Power of Evil getting that bait. Just in the fog of war. It looks like Phoenix has closed himself to the turret. No scatter coming in. The flash is there, though, to get him locked down. Phoenix is going down. There's the orb in from Power of Evil. First blood for CLG.
The patience pays off, Riv. Wiggly wrapped all the way around mid lane. He came from the bottom side all the way through top, knowing that they just have to punish this flash that was burned on Phoenix early on and get that gold in the next 2 minutes, or else everything would be for naught. Gangplank ultimate going down too.
Cannon Barrage right on top of Ruin. He's trying to get that Kingslayer down to get the heal back. Another abscond of a duck, but it's not going to be enough. Possibly a Q coming out of solo. He does have Vision Denial on the brush. Ruin doesn't go over the wall. His summoners are, or his spells are definitely back up for another round, but they choose to back off, fight another day, and here is the play in mid lane once again.
Yeah, Wiggly walks all the way around, and all he has to do is get the slow onto Phoenix. Power of Evil flash Qs to get an extra sphere, then ults to spread spheres all over the ground. That way you cannot miss the stun, by the way. The other option greedier players will go for is just trying to stun off of the pillar so you don't have to, you know, flash and use all your moves and go for the long range, but that can be outplayed. Flashing on top of someone, throwing the Q, and then ulting to scatter spheres everywhere cannot be outplayed. There's no way you can dodge that stun, and that does secure CLG the first blood money.
Wiggly as well flashed in to get that. We'll see if he may need that or it comes back to bite him. Solo slowly farming with his barrels from safety here against Ruin. 56 to 66, but that overall fight, I don't think Solo wants to take it again just yet. They're on Corrupting Potions right now. It was a back from Ruin. You can see his teleports just used. So he actually has the health advantage here in lane to keep bullying.
Plus, he's got the ultimate cooldown advantage.
Yep.
Sylas can steal Solo's ult, and then next time they go for the 1v1, it would be inside of Ruin's Gangplank ultimate. Jungler's trying to join.
He could get rushes here. He stole rushes, going for Solo, but he's got the orange. The orange has already been used. They're gonna get on him with Glacial Prison, and Wiggly is gonna pick up that one.
Wiggly all over the map here, returns to the top side after their fight earlier, and just before Solo's flash comes up, CLG also make that one good.
Calculated.
All right, back to the mid lane here. PoE trying to go for the stun.
Nice little scatter, hits the electrocute, and we'll wait for that to happen again. It's a good back and forth. Now that he's had a bit of an advantage onto Phoenix, he tries to push that health need in lane over and over. Phoenix doing a great job of staying up in CS, though, so he can be the powerhouse rise for his team. He just hopes the kills start coming in. Biofrost getting a little dangerous there, but they do put Hakuo down lower. Another advantage in the bot lane is Echo Fox now is forced to back off a bit. Don't see many turret plates around the map taken just yet as we have a replay of the top lane gank again.
Yeah, Rush tries to come over and lands his stun, but In landing his stun, he allows Ruin to steal his own, as you pointed out. And yeah. That means that while Ruin is stunned, so is Solo. He had already eaten the orange. Stick says by himself.
That's basically Silas. I'm not sure why he doesn't have the line, "I can do anything you can do better," when he steals your ult and uses it on you. It's just so be a line.
All right, bottom side again. Stixay's flash blown, this time by the desynced recall there. Hakko and Apollo were able to chase him down. Last time, the flash was not punished as they had to use it to get away from the scuttle trap crap they were trying to do. Maybe some repeat pressure here from Echo Fox, should be advised toward that bottom side of the map, because there is a decent CS lead that was able to come a lot from the attempted scuttle grab in mid lane realm, but we're gonna have a possible engage.
Biofrost says no, thank you. And maybe Rush doesn't care. Walks right into a blind brush. That's CLG's vision. They're all gonna walk through here as Rift Herald goes down nicely to Wiggly. He's been great on the objectives and that sort over the past few games and really controlling that aggression in his mind of what's gonna be happening and when it's safe to take the objective.
All right, still a very close game here. And both sides do have some decent scaling options. See, Rift Herald immediately activated on the top side. They're gonna continue to try and attack this gangplank.
Rush just on the edge. Both ults are stolen in the top, so Ruin's basically without an ult for this fight. Cannonbrash goes down to save the minion wave and most of the turret. Rift Herald will fall, and Rush is now in the eyes of CLG. We'll see how they can work the rest of the map.
Yeah, a lot of turret plate money going over to this Silas. We mentioned in Champ Select, when that thing gets first pick, you know there's going to be focus for the team.
Of course.
Get some money onto Silas, and it will be very, very big later. Let's take a look, though. Yeah, so we just saw the difference in turret plate money making up a huge amount for Ruin. That is kind of competing with the bottom side, Apollo with the Kleptomancy on Ezreal and the small CS lead that they got from the River Roam play that CLG tried to make.
We only have 2 minutes left for those turret plates to be taken down. As you can see on the map, two on the top side, three in mid, and bot lane still has five. Hakko and Apollo putting up a brick wall. This defense versus the lovers duo of 6A and Biofrost. That's the charm, that's the quickness going down. They're gonna be right on the Hakko. Great health has to come up. Wiggly's coming in. It's gonna be a great pillar if he can get it just in front, but both flashes are up. There's flash number one. Apollo's just gonna be able to walk this one out with the arcane shift, and they get themselves to safety.
Yeah, they gotta be a little bit careful about overcommitting here. Rush is now on the way down to the bottom half of the map. CLG roaming up through the river. Do they have the dragon in their eyes? I don't think they got enough off of Hakko, considering Hakko already chugging a potion, regenerating some health very quickly here, and Rush has arrived.
Oh, unleashes the power onto Phoenix. Obviously not going to be enough right away, but it could be enough to actually tempt this first dragon you were just talking about, Kobe, if Phoenix can't be there for the fight.
Yeah, some small advantages stacking up here for CLG, and they want to push it.
Seems a bit sketchy. Now the team is joining in. I was going to say Aquafox had the upper hand on getting there. Picking up the honey fruit. Wiggly will be nice and healthy once again. And Trundle can usually stay to play for quite a while.
If you check the top lane right now, it also looks like Ruin preemptively stole the Gangplank ultimate.
Ooh.
Whereas Solo's ultimate's not ready yet. So if a bottom fight does take out, it would be CLG with the GP ultimate.
The Cannon Barrage right now would be in the jungle. Great spot to get the team to have to get out. No escapes, really. Uses it on the Tribe Rush, trying to take down Hakko, but Greyhawk's going to save him for the time being. Gets out safely. The pressure still towards that bot side. And it looks like they are going to be able to get the turret plates coming down soon, but Drake going over to CLG.
All right, they're able to eventually stay in the blue buff jungle long enough. They make the small advantages convert into the true objective here. Cloud Drake also picked up for CLG.
Gotta go fast. Like we said, I probably wouldn't tempt too many teams in the beginning, but once you had level six, somebody wanted to get a little extra gold in their pocket. So both teams look for the fight. There's 14 minutes to see the plates drop off mid turret. Phoenix will clean this wave up, just about 2.5 waves behind his opponent in mid lane. Power B will do him great on that Syndra.
Ooh, Pink's here. Rush possibly hovering around topside. He's very low life, though. I think with that low health, Sejuani's got to be worried about Silas turning for a double kill.
That's the bait, though, right? Go back, bait him in. Just don't bait yourself too hard that you are the one going down. He might just take this and head home. Looks like topside will do the same as red buff is taken by Rush. Continuing a fast farm in his jungle. Both junglers pretty even in that sense, but we've seen Wiggly making much more of an impact in these lanes. Early flashes on the solo lanes. and continuing to go for Rift Herald and the rest of the map.
Yeah, very aggressive Trundle. I think Xsmithy and Wiggly, probably the two best users of the champion so far in the LCS. The Pillar, deceptively good at getting flashes out of people and turning to convert on those burned flashes. It's really set up Power of Evil in the mid lane here with the 160 CS, fully completed Luden's Echo. Level 11 now, so you have two ranks in the ultimate.
Yeah.
That's where you're ready to join up with the team to look for the fights, because the level 2 ultimate for Syndra right now, while the rest of champions on the map have fairly low health pools, provides so much in a burst advantage during a team fight. Right now, Phoenix does have his flash, so at best here, this would be a possible flash gained for CLG if Wiggly goes for the gank. But you can see Phoenix is hovering bottom half of the map because that's where his jungler is, trying to play to Rush.
And we've only seen a few times that Rush, coming from the other view of it, has gone mid. Seeing this cleanse on Power of Evil has kind of disrupted the chances they want to put into attempting to get onto him. So a great pick in Summoner's Bell has kind of deleted Rush's chances of really getting to each lane and trying to be able to do something. Small things, like we said, continue to build. 16 minutes hit on the map. We still only have two kills here as Wiggly and Power of Evil stand tall in mid lane. Somebody wants this fight.
Ooh.
That's going to be the missed ultimate from Rush. I don't know if it's the full bite back, as Phoenix having that edge on the back line could be a lot of power unleashed onto now Rush. But it's a back and forth. They can't get full damage onto Phoenix, and that's really the target they want.
Yeah, a couple of exchanged ultimates and about 50% off of both junglers' health bars. Trundle has a slightly easier time of regenerating health with the passive, so if Wiggly gets back to farm, then he should be able to make it right. But Rush as well, chugging both charges on the potion. They want to continue the fight. Bottom lane roams up.
Expecting a big fight here. It's going to be exhaust on Hakua. If they get the Power of Evil to shut down a lot of his damage, he's changed that with the Unsealed Spellbook. Hakua Abyssal Voyages in and can't get the lick to stick. They're forced to back out, but Echo Fox is not deterred from trying to make things happen on the map, even if they don't have an objective to fight for. Phoenix in pretty scary spot here. Piscata of the Week hits. Rotation down from Solo as well. That teleport's not is going to be there from Ruin. Sorry, it's down for Solo, so he makes the long walk back and forth on the beach. Looks like he'll go home into top lane as that fight fizzles out with no kills.
Yeah, attempted move here from Echo Fox to try and catch CLG in the rotation. They do get Power of Evil's flash on the Syndra.
Mm-hmm.
So that may be something to keep your eyes on. Whenever you blow a Syndra's flash, that's a big, big target on the Syndra's back. You did point out earlier the cleanse, and that's a great utility summoner spell versus something like the Sedge ult, but without a flash to back it up, definitely will be a vulnerable target.
Sit and duck right after you cleanse. Void Staff. A quick buy from Power of Evil as he just wants to shred through his opponents with an ultimate one after the other. They think that's the hit, then you get the kill even if Unleashed Power doesn't. Interesting play. Power of Evil always having his own things that he brings in. Let's see what they do with this. Push it into mid a little bit more, but no help too much for Power of Evil. Now Wiggly comes over in Biofrost. I think he might take a hit in the face from Rush, but with the pressure of CLG there, looks like this turret's going down, and Phoenix might as well. One more wave, and that is gone.
Yeah, we just had full resets here for Echo Fox with their bottom lane and top lane going back. Now they're trying to get back out onto the map to defend the remnants of this tower. All the outer towers are so low health here for Echo Fox. CLG on the brink of tipping that in their favor. Bao does go in.
Ooh, deja vu, a lot of the engages when CLG had Sejuani last week happened right here. Well, they were able to throw Suit C9 off their game. There is a miss, Glacial Prison coming in. Damage onto Power of Evil, he's somewhat the focus. Good hits coming in from the Rise, but Phoenix is forced to back now. Rush has to flash out of the fight as Hakuo is the first one in. I should say the last one in, and the first one out of that engage. Apollo now taking quite a bit of damage from the Feathers as Stixxay locks him up, calling them back, and CLG is able to dance around a lot of these.
Ruin!
Here comes Ruin to get into the fight. Tries to throw down the first Q, and it looks like he's in a bad spot now. Almost devoured up by Hakuo on that third lick, but he gets himself to safety, and it was pretty touch and go, but CLG find that mid turret as they wanted.
And if you look at the minimap right now, we've got Rush, or Solo here, split pushing on the top side. Gangplank gonna try and answer towers after CLG staying mid very long time. Mountain Drake gonna be picked up in exchange. I have to say, Rush keeps going for these max range Sejuani ultimates that are getting sidestep, and it does leave an AoE slow behind, but it's not converting into anything that Echo Fox can actually make a play off of unless you get the stun onto a target. doesn't seem like it's really going to turn into a play for them.
Especially double combining that with maybe a Cannon Barrage right away. Both pretty much similar in size and AoE, so if you are missing, at least you're double slowing. You get something out of it, right? 20 minutes, and that means Baron will spawn towards that top side. We'll see the vision start to encroach that way as well. A few pink wards already laid down for Echo Fox that they don't really have to protect, which means those can stay up quite a while and will get good benefit.
All right, I'd really like to see how the Sylas Ryze matches up right now in the side lane. If Phoenix on the bottom side with teleport available can get this wave priority over Ruin and push that up to the tower, that would open up Echo Fox to try and make that cross map play. Mm-hmm. Currently, both of them do have teleports. Echo Fox have a few more with the rest of the team, as well as a lot of the global ultimates. So it should be Echo Fox trying to keep the pressure here on the side lanes and making that play onto CLG, trying to utilize that extra movement. But right now, the key player for CLG is Ruin on Sylas, who's got his available.
The calm guy in the top lane, calling out the calm, cool shots. And it's a very, very close game, as you were saying as well. Just level 14 from Power of Evil hits as we have the quickness in mid again onto Hakuo. He's been able to live through each of these fights, but they still decide to go for him. Wiggly's now taking quite a bit of damage from Apollo. True Shot Barrage comes through, but the ultimate's not going to be able to hit too many members. Apollo gets his Arcane Shift off and to safety after Scat of the Week, but another back and forth fight with no priority targets going down. And it looks like that side lane push kind of fizzled out, and we'll get it once again as Solo and Ruin about to meet back up.
Big defense there for Echo Fox in the mid lane. They make the call not to use any of their globals there. They knew they were safe. And Apollo back on the LCS stage, making his presence felt.
Staying on the back line, staying safe. Hakuo has been able to go in on each of these fights. Apollo's doing his own safety work there. He's got the hard hat on, so he is really working for himself this game, as everybody else kind of wants to go into the fight too. So it helps even more with his red buff on. Iceborne Gauntlet there, and he's looking to get that Muramana finished up quite soon. Let's see where he's at. 643 of 750, so within the next minute or so.
All right, fighting over mid vision here. Hakuo gets knocked up, but he's got teammates around, so.
I know this dance.
Yeah, nothing gonna come of that.
Push and rush out of position. These are those wards that Echo Fox set up before. And look, it's
going
Phoenix.
For it.
He's going right on the turret. Kingslayer's going to give him the health back that he needed. Ruin looking good, and it does not give him the range he needs on the Hextech Protobelt. A quick Realm Warp out, and Phoenix is feeling good.
Welcome back, Phoenix. Returns to the LCS stage, gets his solo kill under the tower in the side lane here. Ryze fully operational, Riv.
He felt that one. Seraph's Embrace goes down, had enough, and then distance himself from Ruin so he didn't get the life sucked out of him.
Yeah, I was thinking before, oh, it's going to be great when, you know, Phoenix gets the side lane and he could push the turret, the minions into the turret. He'll do more than that as he actually goes for the kill. Really nice use of the Rune Prison, by the way. The biggest thing you need to keep your eyes on when going for the 1v1s with Sylas, keeping Sylas at a distance so he doesn't get the big heal. And a really nice job there by Phoenix. You're able to use your Phase Rush, just locks him right in place with the Rune Prison, and able to pull that one out of his hat.
Well, that changes things a bit, Kobe. You're gonna have to see that side lane played a bit differently here. Ruin's gonna have to play much more careful. That turret almost went down with the damage Phoenix put on it after, along with his minions. And he will head right back down to that lane to find Ruin once again. Teleports are up across the map for big plays. And I think Echo Fox is starting to gain a bit of ground. They just have to wait for Phoenix to add the pressure each time and do it again. Here's your pro view replay from Phoenix inside.
I love it too, because once again, there's no wards for Phoenix split pushing here. They're just keeping track of all the other CLG members up by Baron. He goes for the 1v1 under the tower. As soon as he hits that Q, he knows. It's an empowered Q, he's at 50%. Oh, actually, Ruin did get off that one Kingslayer, but it wasn't enough healing. Phoenix killed him regardless of it, then gets back out on the back of it. Now we're back to live, and they're chasing Rush.
Cannon Barrage was going off right away. That Trundle Pillar went out, so the catch potential is gone from both teams until it comes back up, and those spells are happening. It looks like it's going to be a long fight. Airborne, two members of Echo Fox trying to hit the ground running, but Rush is going to be the first one to go down as Hakuo. Next in the eyes of Counterlogic Gaming, Wiggly just misses the pillar. True Shot Barrage back across his Ruin. Skirts out with a sliver of health, and it looks like they're running for the hills, but they may still want the fight. Feather's called back, but a nice denial by Hakuo as he saves Apollo. And it looks like this one again fizzles out with not too many kills. Just Rush going down. Realm warps in. Ruin doesn't know which way to go, George! And he goes down. That's a kill for Solo. Dragon's gonna be in the eyes, however, of CLG. That's three objectives to their name. Then bottom turret could fall after this.
Yeah, great heads up play there from Phoenix to use the ultimate. Nice placement. There's nowhere for Ruin to run. Can't get to the other side or else they don't step in the ultimate. And is Echo Fox getting back their answer kill? But again, the cost is another Mountain Drake for CLG. When you have two stacking up here, you have to be so scared about only a couple members being able to deal enough damage to Baron to get it without any vision here. So Echo Fox number one priority now is to keep ward control around the Baron buff.
Cheeky Hakuo redemption onto Baron. I like it. Here's this fight one more time on the bot side.
All right, Ruin goes in, not happy with what went on the bottom lane a minute before. Chases down CLG, chases down Rush, gets the kill onto the jungler. But then as CLG try and reset here, you know, they get the extra support for Wiggly to walk out. Ruin is half health on the Sylas.
Yeah.
And all alone with the rest of Echo Fox still coming down. You asked me in Champ Select, you know, for a rise, what was one of the big power points. And again, the creative use here of the utility of this champion, chasing down the extra kill is something. I would still say CLG came out ahead much happier with the way that that sets up their objective play for the next 5 minutes in this game. Around Baron, they've already got control wards, so that's where they're going to try and really put the pressure onto Echo Fox.
And honestly, they're set up really nice with the next Drake. It's not something they need to focus. It might be something Fox wants, so CLG could have some time on the map if Fox does want to focus that. Right now, Fox playing defense. They won't have much time to go for any Drakes in 3 minutes. We'll see how they approach this counter logic gaming aggression. Wiggly now on the bot side. Blue buff looking to be transferred over here. Frozen Domain down first. Pinched against the wall, and they already have vision in the brush as Cannon Barrage comes across. Phoenix now gets the shield one more time. Blue buff really helping him dance this one out. We got the Abyssal Voyage right behind as well. Zhonya's for Ruin. Not looking good for Wiggly. The double Zhonya's goes out with a stopwatch, and here comes Biofrost with a save. Quickness comes in. Is that the kill on the Hakuo? Because Stick Save's coming up big with number one. A kill back from Solo as he gets the Retribution. A double kill for the team of Echo Fox. They're going to look for a little bit more if they can get Power of Evil. He tries to scatter, but it's Ruin coming off the other side. Out of the woodwork, he hits the Glacial Prison. That Sticks A going down.
Rush hits the one that matters, gets the double buff. Arrow going up, POE. Oh,
Power of Evil locked in, knocked down, and that's a double as well for Rush. What a turnaround for Echo Fox.
Echo
Fox. Rise to the occasion.
They're going to run straight for the Baron, too. Pings right now. They're going to run up for, let's see, 18 seconds on Ruin. This might get dicey, Riv. Biofrost will be up. Ruin has teleport. Echo Fox making a beeline for the objective.
Doesn't matter if anybody's alts are down, he can steal it. His alt is up. Teleport is there, like you said, for Ruin. He's going to the top side of the map, Kobe. It's going to be Wiggly there. Junglers are 12 and 12. The smites are even, so you won't get an advantage out of the true damage. Phoenix on the damage for the Baron as well with the rest of the team as Haku is trying to play Peel. They get the Cannon Barrage. They don't throw it down just yet, but yes, there's the damage in. Rush is going to be able to steal Baron. It looks like they're walking this one out slow. They'll be happy to lose Phoenix or just Hakuo. No more, though, as Solo tries to put down the barrels and get the slow in. Pillar's there, the abscond, the abduct, the down Solo after a few more hits, but he is able to drop Biofrost in a valiant attempt. Rush now trying to get himself to safety, and Echo Fox gets out with two Baron buffs.
Oh, what a play. Coming down to the last second there, Echo Fox do get the Baron buff, and they've got it surviving on two members. That will be enough to get their push going and try and get some of this gold out of the tower. CLG did get 3 kills worth of money, but it was at the cost of Biofrost, and it really all comes down to how much Echo Fox can get out of this Baron buff push. Ruin's gonna get the remnants of the top side tower, which will kind of inflate the numbers in their favor for the Baron power play.
It will help inflating back to normal as of now. We'll see how much more they can get back. Negative 980 right now for Echo Fox. They can take down this mid lane turret. It makes it much easier for them to be able to get around to the side lanes. They can walk through CLG's jungle. Right now, they have to go the very long way around, and it does not allow them to get the gauges they want. Here we are at Dragon once again, or Baron once again. We'll see what happens.
All right, Phoenix teleports in early. So it is the 5 members of Echo Fox. Redemption going down. As you can see, Phoenix and Hakuo try and play the front line here to try and ward off CLG. But Wiggly goes in. Biofrost gets the double knockup as Hawklo tried to get the Devour there, and it's kind of multiple members sticking around trying to save other members for Echo Fox.
Yeah.
And a little bit of a sunk cost fallacy there as they lose a couple extra members. Solo did get a counter kill on the Biofrost when he went down, though.
Feels good.
So it was a fairly close exchange, and that's why we say it's going to be all about how much can Echo Fox get with their two Baron buffs. They've got one surviving on Apollo and the other on Rushier. Trying to get Solo split pushing bottom, as you can see on this minimap. With a Baron buff, you can empower two lanes to try and get that big advantage. Right down mid lane, and then they've got the second one here with Solo lying in wait, and Rush getting all the way up to the tower. Now, they should get some gold out of it.
What a step forward for Echo Fox. Last week, the Baron call was one of the things that turned the game on its head for them. Getting chased down by the Yuumi, if we remember, was what crushed them after getting the Baron this time. They make the call, they get out with a few members that makes it that much more of an impact. Now positive on the Baron play, and they definitely seem to be righting the ships and things that have given them trouble in past games. Just over 30 minutes here, 7-7 on the scoreboard. Charmed up, almost knocked down. So much healing coming through with the Redemption and the rest of the team just behind him. That's a lockdown onto Wiggly, but he's able to get out right away. Gets his ultimate down, but now it's just a trade back and forth to see who's going to go down first. No perfect picks coming out for either team, but this may mean mid turret finally goes down in favor of Echo Fox and they can open up the map.
Definitely going to be the case here. There's also a Warmog's on Rush, by the way, so he can just heal back up out of combat. He's coming for a re-engage on PoE!
Oh, PoE just gets taken down. Basically 1v1 there. A little bit of help from a Kahakuo, but Apollo comes up with some big damage, and a misplay is definitely going to change the way this game is paced, and Echo Fox is going to be able to stay for a little bit longer. Unfortunately, Baroned up cannon minions somewhat troll you, so they're waiting for the next wave to come through, and they'll finish that damage out on the second tier mid turret.
All right, after that, it should be a reset here to go spend their money. Echo Fox very happy with what they were able to get done off the back of this Baron buff. A lot of money back in their pockets, and they've gotten two late game Gangplank. Solo here, the barrel chains are absolutely destroying the back line. It's so effective against those low mobility back line champions like Syndra. Mm-hmm. For the next one, PoE will have the flash back up. For this one, he did not have flash. Just gets nailed by Apollo and Hakuo. They're back together and they're taking down enemy mid laners.
These are the big brain Scion runners. You can't put things in front of them. They'll figure it out right away and they'll just dissect your strategy. You gotta make it happen. You gotta do it in the blink of an eye, or Apollo and Hakuo are gonna calculate it, figure it out, and put it right back on your plate for you. 2-0-5 for Apollo. Back into the LCS after a few games out, like he's riding a bike, 500 gold bounty on his head. And as you were saying, Solo is having such a great game with these barrels. It's also hard for CLG to run through these barrels to get to Apollo. He's on the back line, firing shots, and he has been doing so much damage to the team.
All right, CLG need to set up their defenses here. There's a lot of Echo Fox wards in their own jungle, especially around this mid lane right now. So it's very difficult for them to see the Echo Fox plays coming. You can see Wiggly trying to sweep out a little bit here, but Rush.
Oh.
Peekaboo.
That's like a gentleman's agreement there. It's like, we don't want to initiate on each other, but I see you. I see you. It's just not the right fight. Up to Baron to make sure you have better eyes on the prize. A good steal. Oh! He steals Rush's ultimate, throws Rush's ultimate, and Rush is going to be saved up by Hakuo on that one. Gray shit, Gray health has to come out if he wants to be saved. Wiggly's taking quite a bit of damage on the front. Rush goes back in for an Arctic Assault to save the team. It looks like he goes down for his efforts as Wiggly comes up with that kill, a shutdown onto Rush.
Well,
Apollo in the front, and that's not where you want to be as Apollo goes down. He's been so safe, and then he goes right for the face kill. Solo's now taking quite a bit of damage as Phoenix is on the front line in front of four, but he needs to get back. That's just a realm warp, but do they do the realm warp again? It's Phoenix almost going down. Here it comes from Ruin. How many are going to go forward? Phoenix is going to go down. There's the abscond abduct, and Ruin comes up huge. This top laner for CLG slotted in and is working perfectly.
Oh, CLG just dismantle Echo Fox there. After Rush goes down, Apollo tries to make the hero play, eing in on Ezreal, and PoE is having none of it. The Syndra flashes forward to get the extra kill on the Echo Fox carry, and that will be CLG taking the Baron buff, taking one more for the road. Nope, Akko's gonna flash over the wall.
Drop that one out the window. You don't need it after it hit the ground. Don't worry about it. Baron over on the side of Counter Logic Gaming. Elder in 30 seconds here. We got 24 on to solo. You could get that ultimate when he comes back up, but it is something to fight for when you have three Drakes on the map. We'll see how this all happened once again. A stolen ultimate from Rush, and it didn't matter for CLG if they missed it. They were in.
Yeah, it was so close here. Look at the re-engage. Wiggly gets the ult off onto Rush, runs away, barely surviving off the double shields from Biofrost, and then Rush ticks down from the drain on him, and Apollo tried to finish Biofrost, but Power of Evil is willing to use the Syndra summoner spells offensively for the game changing team fight right here. Phoenix tries to fight off the rest of the low health members, but he can't do it. Now we're back out to live.
Biofrost is in and out. Looks like his ultimate might have been used there for a quick second as well.
Now Rush, it looks like Rush is in the death chamber.
Rush is definitely in the death chamber. He'll be coming up in about 40 seconds, sorry. To get my eyes on that timer correctly. Three Drakes on that Elder now multiplied for their damage, and this is going to feel great. The minion wave isn't exactly where they want it to be, but CLG can camp out in Echo Fox's jungle. Kobe, what a swing to this game we've had, back and forth, a Baron for each side, and it looks like CLG's able to use it a little bit better here with their map positioning.
CLG coming storming back here with this Baron buff. They're gonna be able to push up mid and bottom lane, not waiting a second. They've got the extra burn, as you can see, and they shouldn't stop here. This inhibitor turret's gonna melt like butter.
They do have the cannon barrage to throw down. My eyes are kind of on Stixxay here, as well as how Biofrost will move and what his targets are. You have Ruin in the mid lane, could go for that solo versus solo, but he'll get help from Power of Evil now. And they are just going around the horn. That bottom turret and inhibitor dropped. The middle inhibitor now getting all the damage it needs to go down. And at 36 and a half minutes, that's the fight. They go in onto Rush. They want to take him down again so he can't get a good reinitiation on the back line. Ruins somewhat in the front as Cannon Barrage goes down. But they want to wait for the AoE to split so they can get their message in with that engage. And it looks like they back out for now. It's not going to be anything that they want to take other than the inhibitor.
That is one tanky Trundle. When you get a Trundle ultimate off on a tanky target, plus then he's got the stone plate, actually gonna heal right back up with his own Warmox, and that will be enough for a reset here for CLG. Their work is done. The mid and bottom inhibitors being down have a very clear pathway to victory now. No surprise about that. Every member heads right back out on the map, up this top lane. They're gonna push for the victory here against Echo Fox. Can Echo Fox mount some sort of defense on the top side of the map? Phoenix is trying to clear out as many super minions as they can before they have to fight this, because they know timing's not on their side. But it's gonna come down to, can Echo Fox get a surprise fight? They have to pull the trigger at their inhibitor turret. CLG are coming for that base.
So I feel like there's a way this can happen, especially with the Rakan change. You see a lot of Rakans activate all outside of a vision now so they can get in before you even know it. Because you have that 0.5 seconds after, if you can nail him in the face with that Glacial Prison, you have a chance or your fight is disrupted. That's gonna be the first turret going down, and almost too late to even stop, or too quick to stop that one, I should say. Biofrost sitting on the outside. Quickness is up. Rush has his ultimate in about 0.5 seconds. That's gonna be Rush's own ultimate going back onto the team. When will he throw his out? They're gonna be onto the Nexus turrets now. And there goes Biofrost to the back of the fight. Solo goes down to half HP. They are able to hit Biofrost, but he gets the safety. They lose Power of Evil in the fight. This is Echo Fox's chance to bite back onto CLG. They lose Wiggly in the base, and now Echo Fox is pushing out slowly, but a lot were fighting Wiggly. Nobody has the chance to catch up just yet, as Hakuo gets there with a Missile Voyage. They're not getting enough kills that they want, and it's taken them a little too long to take down CLG, but they saved the base and dropped three members of CounterLogic Gaming.
Echo Fox survived the push here. Big mistake from CLG to try and go under the Nexus turrets. They have all the timing in the world. With three inhibitors down, they don't have to force it here, but look, Ruin landing that ult onto Ezreal and getting the Devour out means Biofrost decides to go under the two turrets here. Big Gangplank ultimate and big Barrel Chain takes out PoE. That was a full execution. The Syndra just dead from Echo Fox defending at Nexus turret. CLG step too far and get dismantled.
Doesn't mean it's over, it only means it's harder. Echo Fox now keep themselves alive, backs against the wall. You can see Wiggly discussing with his team.
I see, we were here, and then the Gangplank ultimate came through, and then PoE got two shot.
There's a lot of things to keep track of in this fight, especially when you have the Cannon Barrage coming down. You want to avoid Ryze and his lockdown, and then you have barrels in from everywhere. Barrels are the thing that gave the upper hand to Echo Fox, along with a True Shot Barrage. That combination is quite conditional. I'm sure CLG will be looking for it again. So now how does Echo Fox make it happen with a different variety of play? That's the question, and that's what becomes so difficult when a game is so close. Echo Fox is 2,000 gold in the lead right now, defending on their own doorstep. This is a tough game.
They got a bunch of bounties off of that defense there, are able to get a lot of gold back. They still have a lot of work to do because the inhibitors are down and they have super minions that will continue to flood in.
Right.
But winning that team fight buys you so much time.
Baron, that gold.
Baron coming up in 8 seconds here. Believe CLG should be able to burn it down in time.
Yeah, like you said, with the super minions coming in, a little too much janitorial duty to do inside Echo Fox's base. You have to clean those minions up. They will take down your turrets, especially if they're coming in from a single side lane. And True Shot Barrage whizzing on by. Not this time. Two Barons, three overall in the game, one to Echo Fox, the last two to CLG along with the Elder Drake. That's in 44 seconds if they choose to get it again. Enough power to kind of waltz on by that, but they also have enough vision to know CLG can't leave their base, so maybe Elder Drake is burned down just as quick, and it becomes that wham, bam, thank you, ma'am, rush into the base as they head for the Nexus.
Yeah, I wonder if Echo Fox try and make a play to fight. 20 seconds left. They are in mid lane, so it's not too far, but it seems so scary to run into the Fog of War to fight that team fight. You're faced with two very difficult decisions. It's unlikely you can win a team fight versus the Elder Dragon Burn, but it's also unlikely you can win a team fight running into the Fog of War there blind. They're gonna have to try and go for it.
Whoa, Rush is on the front. You are telephoning this one in, man, that you want to get that fight, but CLG knows it. They're
going
to start backing off. Rift Herald goes down. They are more than happy to turn now, and there goes Biofrost into the fight. I love how he used that ult under Wiggly. It almost hit him so he could get that off without being noticed. Apollo's going to be on the front line trying to deliver in the damage. He gets his ultimate stolen. That's just a True Shot Barrage. Not going to pick up the fight too much along the way for CounterLogic Gaming. And now they're going to make their way into the base. Top lane's pushed out just a little bit. Those super minions will bring it in quick. Bottom lane has one of its, I believe, last rounds or no rounds of super minions there. So CLG needs to rework these inhibitors and get themselves back into a position where they feel comfortable fully going into the base. Right now, very strong. And with these buffs, should be able to take the fight. But they are giving Echo Fox the respect of this counter engage.
Yeah, they know they got turned around on last time. Echo Fox don't have a lot of time. Baron buff and Elder Dragon burn on CLG. One inhibitor left.
Do they fight it? It's the whole mentality of I've saved this for so long, now I have to fight it, but that's what happens at the Nexus. It's do or die here for Echo Fox. Do they do or do they die? That's gonna be a resurrecting solo. Stopwatch goes down as well to try and save Rush, but he is gonna fall. Solo's now forced away as one Nexus turret goes down. Rush is towards the fountain. Hakuo is gonna have to use that gray health, and it looks like it's CounterLogic Gaming that are gonna take the win over Echo Fox. What a match back and forth. And they'll move to 3-2.
CLG climbing up the standings here. They beat Team Liquid at the end of week two and are starting off with a win over Echo Fox here, even with Phoenix and Apollo back in.
Feels great. Everybody from the CounterLogic Gaming team coming together to make this work. You're not having kind of one carry standout, but we are noticing that Wiggly is just stepping up so much more each game, and it doesn't seem to be stopping. He's not kind of averaging out from the Sejuani versus Cloud9 to looking at 7-2-8 now versus Echo Fox on a Trundle. And we haven't seen too many people take it out the Trundle, but like you said, playing an aggressive Trundle throughout it.
Definitely a very strong early game from him, getting both solo lanes, flash advantages, returning for repeat ganks as well. Definitely a little touch and go there in the mid game. Echo Fox with a really nice comeback and a Baron of their own. But in the end, CLG with that critical team fight, take it once again.
Not really seeing where Echo Fox isn't finding their wins, but it's definitely something they have to go back and find out because it is going to be a rough split from here on out if they cannot. Let's send it down to now Avali, who's standing by with an interview with CLG's mid laner.
Thanks, guys. I am here with POE. That was a close one coming from you guys. Tell me about the comeback and that fight in mid lane that, you know, allowed you to snowball and take the game.
I feel like we were all like just like talking what we should do, like what every individual can do in a team fight, because their combo was actually pretty annoying. Like they had just so much kite back and like so many like just zoning tools, like barrels, air cues, like it was so hard to like play the team fights out, and like every time I would like step up just closely too much, I'm just dead. So I think in mid lane I was really lucky. Astrid stepped up too much. I got the kill on him, and then we just like everyone just schemed. We got the team fight, and it was really nice.
Yeah, we definitely saw the Ezreal step up, and then you almost got two-shotted at one point. Yeah. So just in a game like that, where it is so close and tensions are high, who's the voice coming out who's saying, okay, guys, we got to pull it together and do this and this?
Yeah, I feel like everyone was like just screaming around. It was really chaotic. I don't think it was perfect how we communicated. I feel like everyone had like so many different ideas and like wanted to be like fancy. I think at one point, like Vincent was like, actually just grab Ryze ultimate and ult us into the Baron pit. And it's like, damn, that's a good idea, but like, there was just so many different ideas that like we just needed to like set on one, and I think in the end we did a good job at it. We were saying like, okay guys, just Baron, like second Elder, they cannot win the team fight. We were saying like, okay, let's not give them an engage. After we get the Elder Dragon, we get the fight, and I think we just played it really smart afterwards.
Well, you have the win today. You had the win against Team Liquid last week. Still really close games. A little bit of inconsistency coming from CLG. What do you think about the state of the team?
Well, I'm just really happy how the summer split is going so far. We are way better in scrims. I feel like the team atmosphere is way more friendly. We have way more fun. It just feels like a different team. Just with Ruin as a new addition, it's just like, he's such a great and nice guy. Like, really props to him. I feel like the team really changed, and it's so much more fun. And like, we just win these games, even if like people do mistakes. Like, I feel like last split, it was just like, if not every one of us is like 120% like on their time, on their performance, we just lose. And today I feel like we did so many mistakes and we still won because we were just like a better team.
That's super exciting to hear. And I actually, I can't wait to see more of this new CLG, but thank you again. And for more on the game, let's hear from the State Farm Analyst Desk.
Thank you very much, Avli. Things seem to be a little bit on the up and up for CounterLogic Gaming as they move to 3-2. Hearing from Power of Evil about how this summer split has gone for them with the addition of Ruin. You may have noticed we moved to a two-man desk, so it's just Mark and I for the rest of the day.
I need all this space.
Yeah.
Ugh.
Kobe's lack of understanding around sarcasm has vacated the desk,
yeah.
So we're all good here. But let's talk about this one because from the side of Echo Fox, we obviously talked about the substitutions coming in for the day, Apollo and Phoenix slotting back in. And I think even from the outset within Champion Select, you saw a little bit of the effect that these two players have on the team.
Yeah, I would say Ezreal Tahm Kench is not something I would expect to see out a loss. And so because they're able to take this more passive poke-focused bot lane that allows Rush to focus more on the top half of the map, and I can see what they're trying to do by allowing Rush to camp top lane and mid to make sure that they secure themselves a good early game, because they do become a pretty terrifying 1-3-1 comp, and even a team fight, as you heard POE saying, there's so much poke and zoning available, they're really annoying. But the early game didn't go well for them. Wiggly was able to get all over the map, and it was really weird. Just the whole game was hard to talk about.
It really was, because as you mentioned, like while there was action in the early game, it didn't necessarily net anything that made you feel like, oh, that's the turning point of the game, or this is this is really the crucial pinnacle climactic moment of the game. It wasn't until the mid game when you started to kind of see the map get pulled apart by Phoenix and him really beginning to draw pressure and attention from CL.
Yeah, I mean, this is like the second or third skirmish in the bot lane. Phoenix got a solo kill versus Ruin. They tried to attack him once or twice. And this is the first time it really goes bad for them. Phoenix kites out super well. Maybe should have cut up towards the Tahm Kench, but either way, this still ends up working in their favor because they have the global advantage of the Tahm Kench, able to bring people into the fight faster. The problem was after they win this fight, they like forced a Baron right after. Phoenix didn't have a great early game, had some good split pushing, but then as fights went on longer and longer, eventually CLG started finding their own fight. So it was one of those games where like every single player had parts that looked great and other parts where they looked a little boosted. So it was hard to identify exactly what each team's win conditions were trying to be in that game, because you see that clear 1-3-1 with Ryze and have global advantage.
Right.
But then as the game went later and later, it was like, well, Baron's stronger and now Elder Drakes are up and you can't split as long as you want to.
Off of that replay comes the first Baron that you talked about going in favor of Echo Fox. But when we talk about individual performances in some ways turning the tides of an entire game, I think in this case, you look at Ruin, specifically in this mid lane team fight where CLG comes out on top. 4-0, track Ruin this entire time.
Right, I mean, he's the one who's really kicking it off, grabs Sejuani ult. Even though it's not perfect, he's still getting his team and the enemy team to blow cooldowns. And then he gets forced out of the fight at around 30% HP. And it's super impressive how he is still able to contribute in this fight over and over again after this point.
Watch his impact. Second ultimate that he's stolen in this fight. Right. There it goes.
So he's able to drop it on top of Ezreal, get some damage in. Then he's the one who actually sets up the next target onto GP. And even though he gets out.
Here comes the third ult steal.
Yep, he's going to grab Ryze's next. And I was...
He's only sending Wiggly, right?
Yeah, I'm like, there is no way he's going to take this Ryze ult. Yeah. He's like, nah, I'm taking it.
Only a crazy person. Oh, but he gets it. Out with a sliver of health. Mastery over that champion in Sylas. And I think I'm beginning to understand why Ruin is being brought into this team. The potential to make individual plays within a team fight to set other people up, some of that mechanical ability, the aggression that has been talked about to come out of this guy, that was a pretty stellar game for him.
Yeah, and I think, you know, there's a lot of room to grow when he's split in the side lane versus Phoenix. Maybe that's where the communication and lack of time with the team, you know, shows its head that he's not able to, he kind of gets collapsed and pushed and punished a little bit. But then in the team fight situations, he was so good. And mm-hmm. It was off that replay, they got their Baron and finally kind of won the game. Still took some time, still some team fight losses, but he was super impressive. And I don't think, this is one of the first games I look at and I say, I don't know if they win that game with Darshan.
Right.
Whereas some of the other ones, you're like, oh, you know, he was in a side lane playing a carry and was mostly fine, but they won because this guy, or they won because this other, like this draft reason. This was the first time it really felt like Ruin 1v9 that team fight.
And while CLG moves to above 500 for Echo Fox, the roster shuffle was not the answer, at least today. On the other side of the break, though, Clutch and TSM square off. If you've been a part of the Bay life since the very beginning, or dedicated to Clutch since they knocked out TSM in the quarterfinals, pick up a team pass in the league store to unlock team-specific icons, chromas, and wards. 50% of all purchases go to the team, so show your support today. Those teams load onto the Rift after this.
Jungler's trying to join.
He could get rushes here. He stole rushes. Going for solo, but he's got the orange. The orange has already been used. They're going to get on him with Glacial Prison and Wiggly.
He's going for it.
He's going right on the turret. Kingslayer's going to give him the health back that he needed. Ruin looking good, and it does not give him the range he needs on the Hextech Proto Belt.
Dino Flash.
Nice.
I W.
Yo, can that's you guys run through that Baron maybe?
Yeah, we can. We have TP.
Go.
Kill him. Nice.
Ezreal shifted out.
Yeah, we got him.
I can pillar. Okay.
Okay. No flash. Go.
He's slow. Right? Set.
I can't get him.
That's just a realm warp. But do they do the realm warp again? It's Phoenix almost going down. Here it comes from Ruin. How many are going to go forward? Phoenix is going to go down. There's the abscond abduct. And Ruin comes up huge. This top laner for CLG slotted in and is working.
Oh, no. Are you okay, Mike?
Yeah, got a pretty big fender bender here.
Don't worry. State Farm's got you covered.
That's great to hear. Robin, what's going on?
Are you sure you're okay?
Yeah, I think so.
We're going to get you a tow truck, Mike.
Thank you. Real fender bender going on here.
Fender bender.
Everybody remain calm. No reason to panic.
Go with the one that's here to help life go right. State Farm.